We will use algae as a functional ingredient in aquaculture. It's a diet for the fish supplemented with algae. I'm Ana Teresa Gonçalves. I'm a senior scientist at SPAROS and research, and I'm also the leader of the animal nutrition working group at the GreenCoLab. The main differences between a traditional functional feed and an algae-derived functional feed will be that, algae are sustainable ingredients. We know they have a great potential, that's why we are working on them. It is an extra ingredient we are putting in the feed, but it's completely natural to the fish, and we simply are putting it in a different perspective for them, while the traditional other functional ingredients normally include ingredients that are very interesting, but they are either not that sustainable or with different sources. So we don't know yet when we start working with the algae, which ingredient in particular. We know the species by what's known on their composition, but we don't know if they will have actually the effect that we expect. This is a very interesting response and shows a very strong potential of this species in particular, of this algae in particular, that will for sure continue to the future as a high-rank ingredient for the increasing the health and the performance of the fish in the systems. When we have the ingredients more bioavailable for the fish to use, after breaking down the biomasses, we simulate in the lab the response of the fish to these ingredients as if the fish had ingested it. So with this simulation, we can rank and we understand which one has better potential to actually go to the in vivo screening to see the full response of the animals. And then we go to SPAROS facility and we produce the feed. So the basic diet is always constructed with all the nutrients that the fish needs to live normally. And we add on the algae for coping with particular challenges. Any kind of stressor that the fish are exposed to, and they are, as we are as well, has a very strong negative impact in the microbiota, in the gut and in the skin. So first of all, I'm searching for these ingredients to keep a balance on the microbiota community, because the microbiota community has a key role in the health of the animals. The samples we are harvesting for the skin microbiota to understand how the algae that we included in the feed are helping out the fish to have a better health and a better defensive system. In the case of locality, we're working particularly with salmon, with Atlantic salmon. My favorite part about this is actually to focus in the mucosal systems, because they are the barrier that separates fish from the outside. So if we can modulate how they defend themselves from the system outside, that is beautiful. And what we have seen is that, yes, we can. So with this project, we can optimize that, and we can actually have a strong input in something that's so valuable for them. So improving these systems that are so delicate and so requiring attention with such a simple and available ingredient such as algae, it's fascinating. I mean, I really get excited.